Hello everyone, in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, I'm going to take a look at one of Rust's collection types, the Hashmap. Now if you're a Java user, the term Hashmap ought to sound pretty familiar. Likewise, if you're a Python user, the word dictionary should ring bells. And Hashmaps in Rust are basically the same things as those two. They're collections of values accessed by way of keys. Now a key in a Hashmap can be any type that implements the EQ and the hash traits. Strings and integers, for instance, are common key types for hash maps. And again, Python users should be nodding along in familiarity right about now. So in this example, I have a hash map where the keys are strings. Actually, they're pointers to string objects. And the values are integers. Now, to initialize a hash map, I can do one of a couple of things. I can start by inserting keys and values one at a time, or I can use what's called a from method, in this case, the hash map from method, to supply a bunch of key value pairs all at once. And that's what I've done here. We have this hash map film years, and we have three movies listed in there, initialized all right at the first time. Notice that we're not explicitly defining types for keys or values. That's inferred automatically from the contents of what we're supplying to from. On the other hand, we need to make sure that any function signatures where we would pass this are going to be accepting the correct types. They're going to have to accept a string and an I32. So when you create a hash map, you can assign it a capacity value. That's the minimum number of slots, so to speak, that you want it to have pre-allocated for keys and values. If we create a hash map using from, that capacity is automatically set to the length of whatever we supply to from. So in this case, it's going to be 3. It's also useful to set or keep track of capacity if you want to avoid reallocation of memory when adding items. This can get expensive if you're doing this in a loop, for instance. So if we want to reserve additional space for more elements, and that way we don't have those allocations performed later under circumstances that we may not be controlling directly, we can do that with the reserve method. And this adds space for 2 more elements, which we will be adding shortly. We can also use other methods like shrink to reduce a hash map space usage if we want to free up elements and then return the memory from them back to the system. So if we want to iterate through the contents of a hash map by key value pairs, that's very easy. The function that I'm showing here shows the pattern for how to do that. It's almost exactly the same pattern as in Python, actually. We use the hashmap's iter method to generate key value pairs in sequence and assign them to a pair of variables that we can then use. I should point out that insert ordering for elements in hashmaps is not preserved. This particular operation will generate different outputs each time. Inserting individual values also isn't difficult. We can just use the insert method to supply the key and the value. If we want to extract a given value, then we can use a match operation on the get method for the hash map. Get returns a result, which we can then process with match. So in this function, we look for a string passed in by way of the variable title. If we find it, then we print it out. And if not, then we just print something else. Get is not the only way that we can retrieve a key. We can also use the entry method, which gives us a little more flexibility. It either returns the value for the key that we're looking for, or if there is no such key, it inserts a value for that key, which we've provided. And in this line here, we're doing that with the movie Aliens. Since there is no such key, it will be added to that hash map with this value. Now, there's only one problem here. That's the wrong value. That's not the right year for that movie. So if we want to modify an existing value, we use getMute, in other words, get this as a mutable value, and then unwrap to first obtain a result value and then a pointer to the actual value, hence the asterisk. And then we can change it by reassigning it, as seen here. Finally, removing a value is pretty straightforward. We just use the remove method. Note that this method returns another result, a sum or a none, depending on whether or not there was anything to remove in the first place. So that's another useful way that we can take action if we must. Now let's run all of this code and see what we get. So first, we see that our hash map's initial capacity is 3, although it does change after that. And then we iterate through the initial list of keys and values. And then we attempt to find alien in that hash map, but it's not there. Next, we insert it manually and look for it again. Oh, there it is. Next, we add and then correct the value for aliens. And there we have that too. And then finally, we remove the key and value for aliens entirely. So to sum up, Hashmaps in Rust let you store collections of values and access them by keys, just like their counterparts in Java and Python and in other languages. We can use match operations or unwrap to deal with potentially missing values when we query for them. And if you have some idea about how many items you want to have in the Hashmap, you can pre-allocate memory for them to prevent potentially expensive reallocations later on. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to Dev with Serdar on YouTube, and to be sure to follow me on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.